You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Here's our finished hand roto. And I'll just scrub through the timeline. It's pretty much in focus for most of the shot, and towards the end, when it's going out of frame, there's quite a bit of motion blur. Looks like I have a shape turned off here. Let's turn that on. And now all the shapes are visible. And I'll turn on my tracking shapes. I was able to utilize tracking for a good portion of the shot until the areas that were being tracked sort of disappeared from view. And then I just did manual keyframing. So I'll just disable that again. But you can see that my shapes for the fingers, which are all kept separate, are shaped nicely. And you can see there's a little bit of a fingernail shape there and the pad of the finger and all the indentations. And one thing I want to show you is how to do incremental nudging. So there's some areas here that could use a little more work. And we'll find a couple of them. So you can see here, it's just slightly off. If I click on this shape here, you can see that it's not quite on the edge. And so I have to do a little bit of fixing on this keyframe. So I'm going to move my point in a little bit here. But I can see it's still a little bit off here. But I want to see if there's a way where I can just move it slightly. So there's nudging in Silhouette. You can either do subpixel nudging or nudging like at 10 pixels, or you can set whatever increment you want. And you can do that in preferences. So first I'll show you how to do it. If I select Command and the arrow keys left or right, you can see it's just moving ever so slightly. And that's because my subpixel setting is set to 0.5. And I've actually had it set to 0.1 at times. And if I want to move 10 pixels at a time, it's shift, arrow, left, or right. So shift, right, you can see that it moves 10 pixels to the right, or shift, left, 10 pixels to the left. And so in preferences, if I bring that up, you can see in the nudging, this is where you can set it. So the default for just regular nudging is at 1, and extended is 10 using the shift key, and precise control is 0.5, but you can make that any subpixel amount that you want. So now I'll talk about shape management and what to do when shapes for the same object don't work partway through the shot. So here you can see when the fingers fold down at the end that I probably can't use the same shape for all the fingers the entire way through. So I chose a shape here that I needed to make to different shapes for. So one is the fourth finger here. So you can see here this fourth fingertip. Maybe I'll just make this a different color. I'll make it pink. Actually, how about a color you can see a little bit better? We'll make it cyan. Okay, so we'll do that. And then we'll go down to the new fourth finger, which is also going to be cyan. And so now we can see them separated from the rest of the hand. So here's my fourth finger in the beginning, and as the hand folds over, I had to swap the shapes out. So here you can see, let's find the fourth fingertip here. Okay, so here we are. So the shape was good till about, I would say, 157, and then I had to turn it off. But you can either just turn it off without dragging it off the frame. There are two schools of thought on this. You can just turn it off and leave it in the frame, but I like to drag it off the canvas completely. And so how I do that is that I find the last good frame where I want to use it. Let's just make sure I am not selected on the new finger, I'm on the old one. And so if you can see that it's selected here, if I go forward one frame, that eventually it turns off. And let's just make that red so we can see it better. Okay, so now it's off. But I dragged it off the frame. If I didn't drag it off the frame, it would sit here. I can just delete these two keyframes here. And when I delete them, you can see it just kind of hanging out. And I can just maybe make another keyframe here, set the opacity. So this is the opacity keyframe. It's on. And I can change this to make this off. And so now when I go to this frame, it's actually off. And V is the hotkey. If you want to see invisible shapes in your viewer, click V. And then click V again to turn them off. But then they sit here. So if you want to use like some of the other features in Silhouette, your shapes just might show up. And so I like to just drag them off completely. And how I do that is I'll just turn this back on. Okay, we'll just enable this keyframe here. Here we are. Okay, so now it's on. So I animate the shape to go one more frame. So here it's on. Let me just select it. And then one more frame. So I'm going to make the shape where I think it would be on the next frame. And then on the next frame, I drag it off the screen. Zoom out. Click T for transform. I have to zoom out even further and I drag it off. So then I make sure that this keyframe is off. Actually, what I need to do is leave it on that frame and turn the visibility off. And then on the next frame, I'm going to drag it off. So here we are on frame 159 and then it's dragged off. So now you can see that my keyframe here, it's on, off, and I can just set another keyframe if I want, and it's off. So that way, it's not going to hang around in the viewer. If the visibility is off, the shape will not be rendered, but it kind of keeps your shot a little bit cleaner. And the reason why I have two keyframes where it's turned off is because if I just had it on and then dragged it off on the next keyframe, you could have some remnants of motion blur show up in your alpha. And in addition, the shape's motion blur depends on the position of the shape on the previous keyframe and the keyframe afterwards. So that's why I have to move the invisible keyframe one more frame to where I think the shape would be, so that the last visible keyframe has proper motion blur. And then the same goes for when I'm introducing my new shape. There has to be some overlap so that the motion blur is correct. So this frame here, we'll just lock this so I don't move it. And so this cyan shape here is our new shape, and we'll find that in our timeline here. So we have the new fourth here, and you can see I have two invisible keyframes at the beginning where it's animating, and then when it finally turns on, it's here, it's in place, it's ready to go. So now my motion blur will be continuous in between the two shapes.